going to talk to you about the art of being the bad guy, okay? We're not even going to get into it in this piece. I am going to spend a few minutes just setting this up for you because there's some principles here that I really want you guys to make sure that you understand, okay? And it doesn't really matter what kind of campaign you're doing. And I went into the promotion business and, you know, fighting specifically where you're promoting, you're building an energy, you're building an anticipation, and you're going to take live gate receipts for people to watch in attendance all the way down to pay-per-view tickets, okay? But it's still promotion. And I do see people in this space all the time not realizing what it is we're competing for. So many times they have to understand we're playing a different game. The game that is being presented in the sport that I came from. But I want to make sure as you guys watch this that you don't think, man, I need to be a fighter to really relate to what Chael's saying. I can be entertained by it, but maybe won't carry it over my life. Yes, it will. I'm in one of the hardest business there is. Getting people to stop what they're doing, mark a date on their calendar, get babysitters, find a date, get tickets in advance, show up, park, walk in through the doors, go in the building, it's really tough. So if it works in this business, I want to encourage you to understand that you can apply it to all walks of life, but it's a simple numbers game, okay? I'm going to jump around a little bit, but stay with me because I promise I'll tie all this in together. Whenever you're doing something, though, anything in life, a lot of it does need to come down to probability. What are my chances? Setting a goal is a really good thing, but I've also seen people ruin their lives for putting it on hold, for setting goals that are not realistic, or that they do not have a strategy for going at a whole bunch of little goals to fall in line to then achieve the big goal. So something that, and the reason I became the bad guy in my space, I'm just looking at the pool, okay? And I'm saying everybody here wants to be the leading man. They want to be the handsome guy. They want to be the well-liked guy. They want to be the cool guy. They're all competing for the same thing. The other end of the pool is wide open. If I come out and I say I want to be the bad guy, I actually embrace this. I want to be the guy who walks in wearing the black hat and who gets booed, who gets people that give him the thumbs down, who they're wadding things up to throw out on the way in. If I want to do that, just by saying I want to do that, I will become number one because I will be the only guy at the end of that pool. And if you can accept that, and then you can relate that, because don't forget, again, when I talk about I came from the world of promotion, people also get stopped on what that word means. And I will hear several fighters within my own industry say, I'm being under-promoted. I'll hear that term a lot. I want to stop them and go, okay, hold on, before you go any further, just tell me what that means. And I see it, they go silent. They don't know. So then I'll feed them a couple of answers. Does that mean your face isn't on enough billboards? Does that mean your name is not on the top of the marquee? Does that mean they don't do enough countdown shows or put you on the .com often enough? No, it means none of those things. So what does promoting mean? Promoting only means one thing, storytelling. Promotion is nothing more than the ability to tell a story. If you meet a great promoter, all that means is that he was good at telling the story in a compelling fashion that made the viewing audience stop what they were doing, mark this on the calendar, make sure they were home that day, sit in front of the television, and push the button. That's it. But you have to make sure that you understand that because every great story I've ever seen, for the most part in my life, I wasn't a big reader. I've read plenty of books, but I didn't enjoy reading as much as I did going to the movies, turning on the television set. I really enjoyed it. That was fun for me. But every great story I had, whether it was on TV or whether it was in the cinema, they all had a bad guy. It ultimately all came down to good versus evil. It didn't matter if it was a movie on politics and was opposing views. It didn't matter if it was a shoot 'em up movie and you got the cops and the robbers, the cowboys and the Indians, whatever it was from the beginning of time. You had a good and you had an evil. And that's the way that you tell a story. When I went into the world of promotion and realized that promotion was nothing more than storytelling, I realized how important it was and how valuable and how bankable it could be to make sure that every story had a bad guy. Because I was it. Now, a bad guy still has to have an art. Make sure when you understand when I'm talking about being a bad guy, I'm talking about an attitude. I'm not talking about a scumbag that goes out and is breaking laws and doing bad things. I'm talking about an attitude. Bad guys don't create drama. We create business. Bad guys do not apologize for statements. We make the statements that other people feel need apologies for. Bad guys think and they plan and they strategize. They know where the lines are and they walk up to the lines, but they don't ever cross them. A bad guy will always have a code. And even though it isn't the same code that other people within society would have, a bad guy will be fiercely loyal to his own code. And that's where he gets his integrity. That's why people then can come on the bandwagon and support him. That's why they are willing to come along for the journey regardless of the outcome. Other people in my space, strictly outcome-based careers. If they won, they get another match. If they win that match, they can get another match. Eventually, they can get a bigger match. Eventually, they can get to a co-main event spot or to a main event spot. Maybe they can even get to a championship fight. But that's a hard way to go. You guys know that. You guys would be able to relate to that. Have you ever had a bad day at work? Sure, of course. And I come from a very unique sport of mixed martial arts, very unique sport. Because you only get three times at bat all year long. So if you get one wrong, you got to wait 4 or 5 months just to have another crack at the bat. It's hard. It's a very tough spot. I see LeBron get them wrong all the time. I see Kobe get it wrong. I watch Shaq get it wrong. I see Tiger get it wrong. 3 or 4 days later, they're up again. They got to make it right. They got to have a good day. Just like you guys, you can relate to that. You've had good days and bad days. Maybe you didn't have a camera on you. Maybe you didn't get caught having a bad day. And the other side of the coin is even when you had a good day, maybe you didn't get the credit that you deserve. But you can at least relate to the fact that if you were to have purely an outcome-based career, you're going to have a very short career. If you are only allowed to stub your toe once or twice and you're out the door, you're going to have a very bad and unpleasant experience. And it's going to be short. It's going to be a very small window. But that's still the world that I came from. So how do you navigate and get around that? How do you get people to come along for the journey regardless of the outcome? And that's where the attitude comes from. That's where the character comes from. That's where a promoter would need you. That's where a Hollywood director or producer is going to need to always have a bad guy in their script. Nobody ever shows up to Hollywood saying, I want to be the bad guy. I want to be the guy that people are scared of. I want to be the guy that people are booed. That people are booing, that people cross the street to get away from. I want to be the guy that they run up and take pictures with and bring their children up to and sign autographs. They're both important roles. And I am not convinced that one can pay better than the other. So if you're going into business, the business of a bad guy is wide open. And it's a role that is extremely important. When I talk about probability, you will see this in all walks of life. I was with a class. I got asked to come in and speak to a group of second graders recently. It's actually 2016, right? Recently seems like yesterday, but a number of years ago. The reason I remember the year is the presidential campaign was going on. And somehow we came along this topic. And I had 30 kids in the class, all sitting down, cross-legged, staring up. I'm standing above and talking to them. Somehow we get on this topic, and I explain to them, just a second, pump the brakes. Before you buy into the marketing of the presidency and of the integrity and of the incredible climb and breaking of the glass, all these buzz terms that you hear, guys, you have a greater probability of becoming the president of the United States than you do being the best reader. I happen to be in English class, the best reader in this classroom. There's 30 of you right here. To become the best reader in this classroom, you're going to have to beat 30 people. Every 4 years, roughly 7 to 9 people run for president. In 2016, 4 people ran. What kind of competition is that? Having a competition that only 4 people enter every 4 years? Man, this is easy. From the world I come from, that's easy. That's slim pickings. And I don't want to put down the presidents of the United States, but in reality, if we want to be real fair about this, it's not all that hard to become the president when nobody runs. So you have to understand, I use that example because I know it's one that you guys can relate to, but the same thing goes with becoming the bad guy. As much as you could raise to the top and become the most powerful man in the world simply because nobody else tries to do it, for whatever reason, whatever fears there are, which I think is largely built in psychological from the marketing of the press, from the power that office holds, that people just say, I just want, people want to vote for me. I don't have the courage to go out there and try. I don't have the courage to deal with the rejection and the resentment. And so many people don't want to be the bad guy. They don't want to wear that black hat for the same reason. But there is nothing more bankable than a cool heel. You could look from James Dean to the great Fonzie Fonzarella. You could look to Stone Cold Steve Austin, or you could look to The Rock. But you have to be cool while being a bad guy. That sells. Controversy creates cash, but how do you be cool while doing bad things? How do you be cool while talking to somebody with a face like this that's very intimidating and point your finger in their chest? That's where it comes back to the code. Bad guy must lay out what his code is, and then he must be fiercely loyal to his own code. That's where his integrity and his worth comes from. Bad guy does not need to apologize. A bad guy does not need to back down. A bad guy takes on all challengers. A bad guy hears the crowd differently, where most people need to feel good with cheers and applause. A heel, a bad guy, a boo. A boo is a heel's cheer. And when he hears it, the louder it is, the more he knows he's done his job. He will stare into it. He will observe it at all times. When he walks to the ring and people are reaching over and trying to touch him, as much as the heel appreciates that, looks at that little 11-year-old kid, sees him wearing the t-shirt, knows that he came out, knows this is an exciting moment. He also knows the camera's on. And those people get paid to see me. They did not pay to touch me. And the heel will walk right past it because he is fiercely loyal to his own code. He won't stop and insult them. He won't stop and tear their sign up just to get a little extra heat. He'd just walk right past, but he'll do it with a straight face. It's an art of a bad guy. You must be prepared. You must understand the power of one. You must understand that if nobody else is in that end of the pool, you could take over the kingdom. You can be the only voter. You can be the only voice. And no story is ever told in the history of time that is ever talked about, made into a play, made into a movie. Story becomes a cult classic, no folklore hero without a bad guy. And in the art of promotion, in the art of campaigning, in the art of business, it is all about bringing people along for the journey. It is about making sure they stay committed for the ride, for the long term, regardless of the outcome, which means you've got to tell them a story. Stories cannot be told effectively without a bad guy. Vince McMahon, one of the great storytellers of all time, okay? People will talk about who the world's greatest promoter is. I hear that conversation a lot within the world that I live. Dana White, Scott Coker, Don King, Oscar De La Hoya, Bob Arum, you hear all these names thrown at you. It's Vince McMahon. And the only reason it's Vince McMahon is he's taking a product that he has openly told the audience, this is not real. We're only going to pretend that it's real. And he can still sell out any arena on earth. Storytelling. But what does Vince do? He's got a baby face and he's got a heel. Baby face means good guy. Heel means bad guy. No story can be told without both. Stick around. I am going to teach you the lessons. I am going to show you what a bad guy needs to do. I am going to give you examples. I'm going to lay this out for you. You may want to join in. You may want to stay away. But you still need to know what's happening and why. If you want to navigate the waters, if you want to take on the masses, and you want to go out there and be the leading man, be the next Brad Pitt, be the handsome guy, be the cool guy, be the one in the sunglasses that paparazzi's running over to, that's okay. I won't tell you not to do it. I'm just letting you know it's going to be very crowded and it ups competition. If you want to cut the line, you can go to the other end of the pool where the water is warm and nobody else is swimming. I will tell you how to get there. Stick around because you are going to learn the art of the bad guy.